Amazing day, huh?
Oh, yeah. Take us to the Blazers.
I was talking about the day, man. Look at it out here. I swear, higher building, bluer sky.
What's wrong?
Your parents are hassling you again, aren't they?
They got a point. No future in window washing, man. No security, not saving any money, that's for sure.
Look, they're just mad because you're not wearing a suit. I mean, so what, you want to be like your sister, the lawyer?
Hey, she's 25, she's on the partnership track, and she makes a ton of dough.
And she's the poster child for job stress. I mean, God, look at this. What more can you ask for?
Gave my notice today.
What?
Can't be a kid the rest of my life, right?
Oh, man.
The directions. Where are they? Never mind. Investigate. What did you call it?
Miraculous.
Miraculous.
Phenomena.
Do you see the guy down in room 26?
Just a sec, Declan.
Huh?
Just 1 second.
Did you...
Mucho trabajo.
That's for patience.
Do you see the caballero in room 26? Hmm? Maybe you don't speak Spanish. Do you see the fellow in room 26? He fell from a story building 200 feet to his bottom with no broken bones, not a scratch on his hiney, nothing.
200 feet.
200 feet, see. Maybe you don't believe me.
You should see this for yourself. Come on.
You got any more questions, guys? Hey, no, it's all right, it's all right.
I think you should just get some rest.
I'm fine, Mom, really, I'm fine. I feel great.
Can I help you?
Yes, I'm Peggy Fowler. I'm with the hospital.
A psychiatrist?
Why do I need a psychiatrist?
You don't. I just thought I'd come by and see if you or your family needed someone to talk to.
He's all right, isn't he? I mean, the doctor said...
We're just keeping him in the hospital overnight for observation.
Oh, yes, he's all right. I spoke with the doctor. So, all this media attention, it's a little bit overwhelming, isn't it?
Oh, yes, it is. I mean, the phones have been ringing constantly.
You've got to admit, what happened to him is pretty amazing, huh?
This is Declan Dunn.
You with the hospital, too?
No, Professor Dunn teaches over at NOU.
Oh, really? I'm at OSU, English Lit. Which department are you?
Anthropology.
He's just a friend of mine.
Shadowing her for the day.
Well, more like a year.
Oh, they got cable in here? I don't want to miss the news.
You ever been on TV, George?
Me? Nah, are you kidding?
Amazing how many reporters crawl out of the woodwork for this sort of thing. You'd think they'd be more interested in the real news.
Well, it's pretty incredible what happened to him, sir. I think most people wouldn't walk away from that.
It is remarkable. I mean, we're thrilled that George is all right.
We just wish he'd get some recognition for his accomplishments rather than for an accident.
I've got to run. Pre-trial motion to file.
Oh, yes. Full docket today.
Will you be all right, dear?
Hands off the nurses.
You're the luckiest guy alive, George. Think about it.
You got a pretty, nice family.
Yeah. Well, they just want the best for me. Susan, she thinks it's a sign.
What do you think?
I think I just fell 200 feet and lived. It's not a sign from God, then. What is it?
It's luck, Declan.
200 feet? Lucky or not, people don't walk away from 200-foot falls. They tend to splat.
Okay, it is remarkable.
Now, and you don't think it's a little bit weird, too, that he should meet me here in this hospital?
You?
Yeah. He's exactly the same as I was after my avalanche. He's a little confused, a little disoriented. He's trying to figure out the meaning of stuff.
If there is meaning...
Peggy, don't play the coincidence card on me, please. I mean, there's meaning here.
Okay, it is amazing. And go ahead, investigate the miracle. Just be careful.
Careful of what?
You took the avalanche as a sign to change your life. George may not be ready to do that.
I wasn't ready at first either, Peg. You should have seen me. It took me weeks to sort out how I felt about what was going on.
But you made the decision to change your life. And George needs to make the decision to change his life, too. It doesn't need to be made by somebody else. I'll see you.
Okay. He bounced off the building. And that slowed him down a little, right?
A little.
Then he bounced off the tree, and that slowed him down even more, right?
A little.
How much is a little?
Less than a lot.
How much less than a lot?
A little.
Could you close those?
These?
I can't see the computer with that glare.
Great view here. So you're an architect, huh? You design these things?
Used to. Now I run the firm. What can I do for you?
I was wondering if I could talk to you about your body shop guys. They won't let me in there to see the car without your permission, so I thought...
Why do you want to look at the car?
Might have something to do with it. We landed on it, so I'd like to take a look at it if I could.
Whatever, just as long as it doesn't screw up my insurance. I've had enough trouble explaining this to them as it is.
Right, I bet. It's a tough thing to explain, huh? You're parked there, and next thing you know, this guy falls out of the sky into your car. But lucky, huh?
Lucky?
For George. Lucky for George. I mean, you know, if you'd have pulled away a second earlier, Pancake City right there on the pavement. I guess it's one of those things about being in the right place at the right time.
Fate, huh?
Yeah. Maybe.
Yes.
Look, I told him the permits are screwed up. He's gonna have to wait.
That all?
Yeah. Hey, do me a favor. Would you call the body shop about the car so I can get in there?
Fine. It's fine.
Okay. So it's a classic, huh?
Yep. That's why it's expensive to fix.
Hard to get parts for?
I got my sources.
I'll bet. A gold mine you got going here, huh?
Yeah, strictly legit. It's expensive. You gotta find all the original materials. Like these tops, hard to come by. Especially these 79s. Material's a lot stronger.